good morning, listeners. Thank you very much for helping us spread the word. It's been a very busy night for first responders and hazard management and the coordination unit. We have just met as a strategic command coordination group, and the idea is to get sort of high-level strategic plans as to how we're going to move forward, really understanding what everyone's doing, so the common operating picture. So we had fire around the table, regiment, Coast Guard, we had sister islands, obviously Deputy Governor was there with us, and CabSec and so forth. So it's very much a multi-agency, clear understanding about who's doing what. You know, obviously we talk about road closures. We've seen serious road closures around the Harbour Drive earlier on today and last night. It came in quite early. So we've had to extend those to a certain extent because, of course, the waves just keep coming and are coming in pretty full force. You would have seen that schools have been closed this morning. That decision was made early morning because of the conditions of the roads and the gusts. And obviously, Kerry, my friend here, will talk more about the actual weather. But the gusts have been posing quite significant issues. So hence why the decision to close schools. And we have seen a lot of debris on the road. And of course, this has a real implication on driving safety and making sure that, you know, obviously your vehicles and so forth, taking really, really heeding warnings and making sure you're not driving in any way that's not responsible. We had to open the Red Cross shelter this morning as a precaution. We have had a couple of evacuations during the evening and more so early on this morning. So the Red Cross shelter is open. That's a Holder Avenue. Obviously, there's two other shelters on standby, one in West Bay and one in John Gray High School. So we are looking at those to see if the need that arises. Obviously, we will not open those unless we need to. But of course, the teams are very much on standby. Please, a massive appeal to the public, please do not go near the coast. We appreciate the waves, they're a beautiful thing to see, but make sure you are as far away as possible. We're really trying to encourage people to stay, hang tight, stay at home if you can, work from home if you can, and so forth.
Yeah, well, currently we're still under gale and marine warnings. Throughout this morning, we still expect some 30 to 35 knot winds with higher gusts. The winds are expected to taper down a bit by this evening, reaching 25 to 30 with some higher gusts. So our gale warning might continue through perhaps this evening, because tomorrow we expect winds to fall back to 15 to 20 knots out of the northeast direction. Having said that, with the winds, we still have these marine warnings. This morning, we're still carrying about 10 to 15 feet wave height. Swells could add to that. But again, as the winds subside, so will the winds, although there's a lag in the difference. So even by this evening, we may still see some 8 to 10 foot waves and tapering down even further tomorrow morning. So from our point of view, the marine warning will likely to be extended and probably shift to a marine advisory possibly tomorrow morning. Rainfall doesn't seem to be much of an impact or a concern for us at this time, which is helpful for any impact assessment and coordination efforts in that regard. But again, to echo what Ms. Coleman has said, we ask the public to make sure that they don't venture near the water and stay out the water. And if you have your vessels, make sure that they still stay in safe harbor. And just continue to heed the messaging from the government, hazard management, and stay safe.